Right, so today I'm going to talk a little bit about the symbiotic relationship of us humans here on this planet Earth, and how come flus like this are happening that are so deadly. I believe it's because we are not acting as a symbiotic self, a symbiotic organism, a group of organisms that have a reciprocating effect on the planet. Instead, it's you know, really, I mean, you think about it, you talk to your own brain for a minute. It's like, wouldn't you like to have a nice big house? Wouldn't you love to just have like your own castle? And everybody's just like, it's impossible to say no to that, isn't it? It's almost patently impossible. So imagine every single billion of us having that same want in our brain. You know, if even for a moment, you know, that's completely unfeasible. You know, we can't support every one of us having a castle. We can't support every one of us having our dream home. And yet, that's there. It's triggered in every one of our wanting, greedy minds, you know. And so here we are as humans, you know, we've come about, we came out of those trees with the monkeys, and we ended up out on the savannas, you know, probably because we fought and even maybe created some plagues then. And then now we're out on the savannas and having to eat sugar beets. And so we eat the sugar beets, and now we're in Africa, and all of this is going on, and it's just like, well, what is it, what's going from that moment, you know? Same deal, you know? It's about the greed of the want of the food I have to eat, of course. The greed of the want I have to shelter. But now there's so many of us that they've created like the slave class. Not the slave class from the past colonialism years, but they have created still a peasant slave class. And we call them the poverty level. We call them manual labor, we call them all those things, but they're still really lower wage earners. And so those lower wage earners, they just do the bidding for the upper middle class and the rich and the super rich, okay? So you have those, the still, you know, even the lower echelon peasant class is still wanting that, you know. They're not going to be, oh, humble life, you know, whatever, you know, I'll just sacrifice whatever for you. You know, they're not doing that. They still want, you know, every single one of us just wants greatness for ourselves, for our survival. We don't want to suffer, all of those things. So we have all those things going around in every single one of us. So we're quite a greedy bunch, you know, each on our own. We're very greedy. And there's no denying that, okay? So you take yourself, you can look at that video. There are many videos of the Wuhan market. One of them did have the snakes, the live snakes, and the live turtles, and the live, like, hedgehogs, and how people just order them right there, and they're all, you know, in their pots and their pans or whatever, and then they fry them up, or right away, or they take them in a sack home to cook, you know. So all of that's going on, and, you know, And that in a way is meat eating. That is meat eating. I don't care what type of meat it is. It is just meat eaters. You know, those are people who have a diet that they will not adjust. They will not change. They want to just keep taking and taking and taking, taking lands from those animals, taking the and for their own houses, for their own riches, for their own castle, because, you know, all billion, 7, 8, 9 billion of us have to have a castle. So they're just going to keep taking and taking all of their lands for their castle. And they don't care that they're all crammed into their little pens and their nests are gone. They don't care that. They just want that eating moment, that satisfy, and so they can go off to their castle, you know. So that group is it's an inherent greed want group, okay? And changing them, you know. Oh, great! You know, they can open up the city right now. I think they have plans of opening up the city again. but to the same old, the same old stuff, the same old take, the same old mean, the same old aggressive on our planet, the same old greedy. You know, when in reality, all their little greedy is going to end up, most of them will end up with a little tract home somewhere, and they're not going to get the castle they wanted. And maybe they get some nice linens, maybe they get some nice clothes, maybe a nice car, but they're never going to be rich, they're never going to be the super rich, they're never going to be making the rules for our society. They're going to be still in the lower echelons, just chugging along, feeding a bank. That's it. That's who they are. They're going to be chugging along, feeding a bank, and eating all of the animals up as they go. No matter what type they were. Oh my gosh, I still visit one of those videos, the Wuhan Market videos are out there on YouTube. And there was one that actually had the food that was more cooked. It was an alleyway. That one was quite interesting. You know, it showed the pig's feet, showed the frogs on sticks, that type of thing. So when you think about, you know, they're who they are, you know, as people, as a city, as a group, and this event happened, you know, is there a reconstruction going on in their brain right now? Like, hey, you know, maybe we did the wrong thing here. Maybe we need to rethink. Maybe we need to reorder how we are as human beings. Maybe Wuhan right now needs the eyes of the world on them, saying, hey, you know, you guys started this. You started this with your greed. You started this with your want. And this is the second. We've had the SARS come out of China as well. Another greed want started in one of those markets. Again, you know, go ahead, blame it on the birds, but it was the greed want that you wanted all those birds to eat. You know, it's the greed want. You know, you can't have your castles. You can't be king right now today. You can't be satisfied. You can't all be Donald Trump and rich and have gold faucets. So you know, take it out on the animals. You know, that's who Wuhan is. That's who those Wuhan people are. That's who those Chinese markets are. They're taking it out because they have not developed a symbiotic relationship with this planet. They don't care to develop a symbiotic relationship as a human being to this planet. They care to take because they are not getting king, they're not getting queen, they are not getting what they wanted. But they sure as hell can take a snake and eat it. They sure as hell can take a frog and eat it. And they can take a pig's foot and eat it. They can take a quail and eat it. And yes, a hedgehog, and they can deep fry it in all the fat they want and eat it. So we have got to look at the constructors here. Who constructed this? And it goes back to the greed and want machine and their dissatisfaction with who they are. And well, they can eat like a king, you know, they can eat and just, oh, you've seen those old, who are they though? You know, that, well, that's their kings, isn't it? That's their emperors, that's their Chinese diet. You know, that's what they have been conditioned to think, that's what a king would eat like. You know, the barbecued frog leg going around in a circle or something. That's what they think, or the intestine of a duck. Going around in a rotisserie, just the intestines, you know, just want the intestines today. You know, I mean, the order of allow, first of all, they're allowed this, you know. All these people are allowed to just be, well, I'm a faux king. I can't be a king for sure. I can't be the richest man in the world, but I can eat like him today. You know, I can be that piglet and I can eat like him. I can take, I can carnivore, I can take, and I can destroy, just like him. And that makes me a man, and that makes me a woman. That's who they are. That is not a symbiotic relationship with our planet. That is just the greed built for their little castle that they'll just ever have to pay a bank. And all for was King Richard, and you get the big turkey leg at a Renaissance fair, you know, every day. You know, that's all they are, eating that fat, that extra fatty food. Anyway. Yeah, and was that a racial slur? No, there's nothing racial about it. This is serious reorganization here has to be done at their diet. They have got to just wipe out all of the animal eating in those markets. I am not kidding. Every animal has to be, we don't no longer sell animals in our Chinese markets ever again. We've had two major plagues brought to you by China, you know, all stemming out of these markets. So we have no choice but to look at them and say, hey guys, you know, you have got to change your ways. You can't keep this up. You know, you're killing people all around the world because of your fanaticism that you didn't get to be king. Your fanaticism that you don't have a castle in France. Your fanaticism that you do not have billionaire status and Lear jets everywhere, and you're not sitting in your rose garden with 275 different varieties. No, you don't have that. All you have is a frog on a stick. Okay, we can go back to, who is it? The pedophilers. Pedophilers, they have the power trip on, like, the lesser. This is like a pedophile event on the animal. You know, the animals out of the wild, the animals out of domestication, raising. They're just like, I have to take the power over. I have to take the power over that lesser. It's all about man taking the power over a lesser, because they don't have their castle. But they had to go to work today, and their only satisfaction is that grisly fat coming off of a pig's foot. Anyway, that's all I have to say today. I don't have anything else. I really want a symbiotic relationship built. And I have even said, block China, embargo them, and such high taxations on them that they cannot sell out here anymore. They can't put limits on them until these markets are made appropriately and safely. And none of this garbage is going on where people are picking up giant cobras and taking them home for dinner. None of that going on any longer. Okay. Anyway, when you think about, you know, the past 3,000, I'll go 5,000 because I think we've been pretty greedy for the last 5,000 years. But the 3,000 years was really when we started getting into the agrarian society, where we started tilling the soil and then saying, okay, I've created this wheat and I am going to sell it at the market and they can make bread. That agrarian society really began, you know, all around the time of the Bible also. Agrarian, you know, Christianity, we had the two, we had there were the two brothers at the Bible time as well. My grandpa will get mad at me at this one for not remembering, but yes, there was Cain and Abel. There you go, Cain and Abel. And I believe it was one of them was agrarian, and the other one was we're not agrarians. We're going to be herders still. We're going to be Berber sheep herders. And we're going to not do that route. And we don't take your Bible. You can cram your Bible up your patootie. And the other one said, no, we're agrarian and we're making Bible thumpers now. Okay. So that's what really happened with Cain and Abel. Okay, had we stuck with the one brother that went off to the sheep herding and there was maybe some cheese made and we lived in yurts and life was simple, we would be doing pretty well. The planet would be doing pretty well. It would be a nice symbiotic situation. The nomadism would have gone on a lot longer. We would have not been forced into a situation household where we are forced to sit in a house and pay it off for 20 or 30 years of a life. We would not have been in that situation. We would have still been allowed our nomadic self, which is a symbiotic self to the planet Earth. Because as being nomads, we're not setting up water sewage treatment plants. We would have moved from that area, and those soils and from the deaths that were left behind would have been rejuvenated. And we walked on, and then we dug up a little bit, we lived there a time, and then we moved on. That's a rejuvenation group. But no, instead they got cast into the Bible thumpers. Okay, well, the Bible thumpers are stay and stay put. There's a bank that owns you. Okay, all the way to the Vatican. There is a bank that owns you. And so you have to stay in that apartment, you have to stay in that house, and even now we even have a stay and hold order going across the United States, America. Even now in Texas, we have a stay and hold order this evening, which is very exciting for Texans because they don't like to do what other people tell them to do. So this is going to be very interesting if that $1,000 fine gets reenacted again and again and again and again across the state. But this is not about stay and hold orders. This is about how our society got constructed away from being symbiotic, away from a symbiotic relationship with nature, one that is just pure greed for the castle self. The pure greed for I have to have my own kingdom, my own castle. I need to have 300 varieties of roses in my gardens. I have got to have a goddamn lake or I'm going to kill myself. I need swans. I have got to have rowers on their boats every goddamn day. Just telling me how rich I am. Okay, so that build up happened because we were situated, we were forced to stay in place. We were forced to stay in place by churches. Churches forced us to stay within that community, to stay in our agrarian lifestyle, where yes, you raise squash, and if you're in the desert, don't you dare raise squash without putting something over it, like a corn. Or a sunflower, do not just raise squash, they will wilt. Those leaves do not like the direct sun. Okay, so yeah, you are out there raising things. And you're going to bring it back into that community market, and that's the plan. And you go to that community church, and that has been the plan. I don't care if it's Presbyterian or egalitarian or a Catholic or I don't know, they're a Lutheran, okay? I don't care if it's any of those. That has been the plan. You sit there, you bide your time, and you raise things for the society of the community. And we're stuck in place, pal. And we pay, guess who? We pay the Donald Trumps. We pay the banks. We pay. We are forced to pay. So there is the richest, 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 richest that has to happen. Because we are a community. We live in a house and it's situated and we're forced here for 30 years. And so the richest, 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 richest gets to happen, gets to occur. All because of those two brothers. The one that said, no, I'm going to make them agrarian. And this one said, uh-uh, go the way with the sheep, man. Go the way for the sheep. Be herders. What the hell? What would you do that for? Agrarian is so much work. Anyway, so here we are now. We're in this agrarian build-up that's built up to World War III's and probably IV's are going on behind our backs. So all of this is happening. And guess what happened? We're not being symbiotic. There's a bunch of you that do try, and you try really hard, and you're out here voting every day, and you're trying to stop this, and you're trying to buy that correctly. I know there's a few of you that do that. But for the most part, a lot of you do not. You are just simply out for your own selves. You're out for your own castle. And then when you find out your own castle isn't there, then you just want to eat a frog on a stick, just like in Wuhan. Then you get so gross that you want to eat a bird's head off, a little sparrow in France. You want to go to some crappy guy's house and who's a cook that they outlawed. And you're like, you're so rich, you can go eat the bird's head off at dinner. Yeah, that's how disgusting you get. You know, so you didn't have the symbiotic. So you're a bunch of spoiled brats. You're stomping in place. I didn't get it. I didn't get it. I didn't get what I wanted. I wasn't born into the right family. It's my mother's fault. It's my father's fault. It's everybody's fault, you know. When in reality, you can even go back to those two brothers, and blame that brother that sent us off into agrarian. You can blame him. It's his fault. Because your odds would have been so low for you to ever be as rich as a Trump. Your odds are so low that, just forget it. You were only ever going to be a feeder into his coffs, you know, into his banks, a feeder into his artillery of casinos. You were only ever going to be a money feeder. So, anyway, how do we switch to be symbiotic now? I mean, I would love it if we all became herders and we just said, that's it. You know, I have my sheep. I'm going out. I have my darling goats. I'm heading out and I'm going to take them for a walk every day. And they're going to make droplets everywhere and the land will flourish. And I'll take them off to the Rio Grande. I'll take them for a walk and walk them back up the hill every day. That would be marvelous. You know, if we all started that lovely little lifestyle. But it's not the way it goes because we're still stuck in these houses that they set us up in. You know, we're set up in this ritual that the economy that one brother created. Okay, that one brother, the agrarian brother, got us into this mess. So anyway, so now we're all running out, and I'm myself running out. I've had all kinds of things in my garden planted, and I have no choice but to make a garden bounty happen. I have no choice, even to do that simple task, you know, of agrarian. I have got to do that because there are so many of you that have flown away from even that level. You're like such a high little king or queen or princess in your mind that you never ever would ever raise a squash or ever even grow a corn cob, you know. So yeah, so that group is finding out now they're staying at home, and well, this is cruddy, you know. There's no food anywhere in their garden. This is cruddy. So that group now is going and seeing themselves and looking at themselves in the mirror and going, oh, great, great. He put another $1 trillion into the market or something today. Great. You know, you're all just yelling into the top of your lungs and cheers, three cheers for him. Trillions of millions and billions in the market. Or to the people or the public. It doesn't matter. We're all getting the trillions. And guess what? You're all going to have to pay for it one day. So a big happy market pop of 22%, you're going to have to pay for that one day. You don't just get free money. You're going to have to pay for it. And guess who pays for it? We pay for it. We pay through it through taxation. Okay, so that's all going to come right back. Every little penny that's gone forth to this little so-called hoax by some of you of the Wuhan flu, every little penny that is being sent out there, every little penny is a, I think I have to hang this up. There's a doorbell ringing. Anyway, every little penny that is sent out there on this is going to come back and bite every taxpayer. You're going to see taxations go from your little 15% up to 25%. Or 40 in some cases, just like they have in Sweden, just like they have in Finland, just like they have in Norway. You're going to have really high rates of taxation, EU style, brought here to the United States, because there's no way to pay for this. Okay. Anyway, unless you change the economy completely and switch to my version and do a property sales tax. You know, you do a property sales tax as your... Oh, that was, by the way, I know what that was. That was a delivery person. And they delivered 10 pounds of raisins. Isn't that a funny thing to order? 10 pounds of raisins. Yeah, I figured, you know, that's the one thing I always forget at the store, and especially when all this pandemonium is going on. I don't want to be at the store looking for raisins. So I ordered 10 pounds, and so they should last maybe a year and a half. I hope so. Yeah, a long time. Anyway, and so we have that going on. That we're going to have to pay for it. It's going to be a really hefty tax. So the market doesn't care. See, the market doesn't care that you're a taxpayer and you have to pay a hefty tax. That's the deal between you and the government. You see, the market is lots of little individual companies here. A lot of little individual companies, and as long as there are those monies are put out to prop it up, well, great for them, you know, that's like free money, you know, they don't care who's paying for it, you know, so go ahead and enjoy the market swoo-swa, because that's all it's going to do for a while. And he'll probably pull out, my verdict on this is maybe up to $15 trillion within the next 6 months. And anyway, we'll see if that is going to be a true number in my Nostradamus brain, $15 trillion. But it's going to be a bundle. And it's going to all be paid for by you guys. And we're not going to have any Social Security, my age and younger, all brought to you by this Donald Trump and this insidious market that just apparently has to be a greed machine and has to be propped up at all costs. You know, just prop it up at all costs. Okay. Anyhoot, back to our symbiotic. Symbiotic? I don't know. You know, it's like that's out the window. It's almost like the only thing that is anybody cares about is that stupid goddamn financial market. That's the only thing. Those Fortune 500 companies. Okay. Anyway, shame on all of you that you're not running to my government and installing it forthwith. Shame on you. Shame on those that are eating hedgehogs in Wuhan. to this day, just shame on you. There are so many shames to go on that when we come to a symbiotic symbiosis, my God, we were never supposed to be like this. We were never supposed to be like this. You know, we're just animals ourselves. You know, we make droppings that, you know, rejuvenate the soil and then things grow. You know, we were never supposed to be like this. Such a greedy goddamn bunch. Anyway, as long as the greedy goddamn bunch continues, we're going to keep having plagues. We're going to keep having another flu, even far worse than this one. And it's just going to keep happening and keep happening and keep happening. So I suggest every one of you invest or buy or build or create face masks, because those face masks are going to be our future.